Barong family, in one sentence, I would say we are gangster nerds.
I'm Nils, this is Jim. We started this thing called Yellow Claw like 6 years ago. And right now we're doing the second Barong Family studio album right here in Shanghai, China. It's kind of cold in here, but the vibes are good, so those are gonna keep us warm.
One of my favorite things about the week so far is, you know, actually being here in Asia for the first time.
I think it's really cool that a lot of people from the label never been to China.
The coolest things is like the vibe here is so good. That everybody just nice and so friendly and willing to tell you a lot of things that you don't know.
Back in the days, I remember when we were stuck on like a new project or whatever, we did it a bunch of times. We just rented a cottage, 2-3 hour drive from our normal studio, brought our laptops and start producing over there in like this crappy setup, but the change of scenery brought something loose.
I just came from a holiday and I didn't produce for a month. My mind is empty, I'm feeling good, I'm feeling creative.
Everything's new, weird food, weird, you know, everything, like, it just works.
Describe the Barong family in one sentence. Family is everything. Family is everything.
Family that's open for any genre and for anyone that has a creative mind.
You see real people, you see real love for the music.
A legit platform for musicians to create anything they want to create and release it whatever they want.
Nailed it.
A super huge, multicultural, multi-genre melting pot.
But to me it's interesting because Barong family started with only Dutch producers and DJs, and now it's like worldwide. We have members from Jakarta, members from Texas, members from China, members from Amsterdam. So it's a blend of music that you don't find in any other label. My music is has more Caribbean influence. Yellow Claw has more EDM, and the mixture of that, it's something new. So for me, in one word, Barong family stands for innovation, creativity.
A universe imploding, and it exploded into like a million stars that's just like forever like expanding, you know? Yeah.
I think it shows that it's not just about music. It's also about having friends that believe in you and that believe in you as an artist and you as a musician and you as a person. You know, that's what a lot of artists could use, you know, to have like this group of friends and this group of brothers and sisters who have faith in what you do.
We got cars, baby, 20s, 50s, 100s.
Do you want it? Do you really, really want it? We got cash, baby, 20s, 50s, 100s.
Shake it now, pop it good, pop that shit just like you should. Shake it now, pop it good, pop that shit just like you should.
I like that.
You know, after like a year of figuring out what this was and what this is, we started using it as a vehicle just to do cool stuff. And yeah. You know, we do that with Yellow Claw. but we also do that with Barong Family.
It just started out with like releasing our friends' music. Sesco, Mike Savello, Rebek, Moxie.
Way before Moxie, I was just trying to get out there with my music, and I was working with a lot of major labels, and there's no freedom at major labels, and there's no loyalty, there's no passion. It's just an industry.
Like Moxie and Mike Savello, those are their first releases ever.
I made a song called Smack. Jim from Yellow Claw came to my house and he said, yo, I want to release this song. And that's actually how it started. That's the first EP and the rest is history.
They went from demos in their bedroom to releases, and when Yellow Claw grew and when Barong Family grew with it, our surroundings got bigger and bigger, and you end up in bedrooms of a young producer in Jakarta.
My name is Sek. I'm from Jakarta, Indonesia. Yeah, no one gave me a shot. Like, basically, I would show it to like local labels, and then they would be like, oh, you know, it's not radio friendly, like it's too weird, it's too hard. Barong Family is the first label, the first group of people that gave me my first shot to be something.
They really cared about the local artists. They gave a lot of opportunity and to have a chance to show their own music to the world. I think that is really important, because like compared to Europe or compared to the United States, a lot of Asian artists, we don't have that much opportunity to show our own music to the world. So I think Barong Family make a lot of efforts on this part.
I personally think it's really cool that Barong Family, that like the label has the power nowadays to give talent a shot.
Through Barong Family, I met like Mike Savello and Sesco. I didn't know these guys before.
When somebody invests the same energy in your project as you do, it just becomes fucking fire.
I mean, it's so much more than just putting music online. It's a vehicle to do really cool stuff with our friends. Personally, I think that we're still the biggest fans of the label and the music that's coming out. I'm like super into the music everybody creates, you know, all the stuff.
Being back in Shanghai, like, I always say, like, and how? And now everything is awesome. Like coming here and seeing people like Vivian, like label managers, artists, and people who set this all up, and being able to hug them and feel them and be like, yo, you guys are really here. Like we're all in Shanghai. Like having people come from like the Caribbean, like Manasa, having people come from like France, like Azar.
The favorite thing of this week for me was to meet new people, new culture, new sounds. New vision. I'm very excited to work with new people I've never met. Mike, Savello, Wewek, Yellow Claw, and new people. I discovered new people. Menesa, I didn't know him.
It's very interesting being in a house with different studios, different producers. You know, you walk into the one studio and they're making a totally different music than the other studio. Gives me also more creativity, you know? Like you hear different sounds and you learn also, because when they're producing, they're talking, right? Like you can do this, you can do that. So it's also a great learning experience for me.
Like four short snares. Well, they come. Or two simple toms.
Dun, dun.
So me and Wewek, we know each other for a long time, and so sitting together again with him in this studio here in Shanghai was really good.
Ooh, we can make him heel dromerig maken natuurlijk.
The energy was very high actually. We were feeling it really good. Yeah, we had this idea of making a real festival song. At one point we just got there and yeah, smash hit.
Like my favorite music was when I stepped into the house. I started working with Azar, and after that I started working with Manasa. And then after producing for like 5 or 6 hours, I was like, damn, I'm here for like 6 hours now and we already made two really good songs. Sometimes it just amazes me like how quick nowadays we can create a good piece of music, you know?
Of course, like, we're in a lucky position that we are able to do stuff that, like, you're able to, like, travel around the world, you're able to, like, meet people. For instance, the girl Lexi that came in last night, we made a song with her. She's from Beijing. We met her, like, yeah, two months ago at a festival. She was performing there. And, last night we made a really cool song with her. I was delighted to do a song with a local artist.
If you think about it, that we met an artist like a month ago in Shenzhen, and now we're just making music for, you know, it was like we're a day deep in this studio week, and this girl flew over from Beijing to Shanghai to do this with us. If you really think about it, you know, that's really cool.
Wish I could have been.
Hi, I'm Sunano. I'm originally from Taiwan, but I've been living in Shanghai for the past 10 years. I think Barong Family is influenced by Asian culture because, yeah, that's an interesting story that, you know, Barong is actually the lion in Indonesia, right? But then actually the lion was brought by Zheng He, which is an explorer. It's in the Ming Dynasty. The first year of Ming Dynasty, the empire actually sent this guy Zheng He to go through all Southeast Asia, and then he brought in all these traditional Asian culture, Chinese culture, and then the lion thing, it was originally the dancing lion of China.
There are so many Asian influences nowadays within the Barong family, with the sound, with the artists. There's a certain respect for all the people that are working with each other. Asian people, they respect you as a person. They're very open-minded people. They're very friendly. And the Barong family supports the same values and metrics as the Asian culture, I guess.
The music industry in Asia is gonna grow, obviously, and the artists are gonna grow with it.
It's like rapidly developing in the past 2 years, and then I think in the next 2 years it's gonna be crazy. No one will know what happened.
It's also a revolution going on. I think the East and Asia is the last place where all these physical things is still growing. Like, how do I dress myself when I go to the club? How do I dance? What do I drink? How do I flirt with other people? Like, how do I connect? How do I dance to this weird music these people make?
And I feel that that us artists need new markets as well to perform and to share our music with. And I think when we play every show in Asia, it's special in a way. You know, it's a unique culture, and people experience music in a different way, and it brings new elements to our music as well, a new inspiration to the Western music as well. So it's I love it. I love this connection.
As Yellow Claw and as Barong Family, we vibe with Asia. Like, we used to go here, like, on holidays. We used to, like, start playing here, like, I don't know, like, 4 or 5 years ago, like, doing shows in, like, Thailand, doing shows in, like, Indonesia. At first, just to be here and just to play here and just to, like, try to meet new people, you know, and do, like, really cool shows. But we were always really attracted to this side of the world. And that pretty fluently blended in with the rise of dance music in Asia. So when that really popped off, like, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, and it's like a wave the label just took.
Yeah, I think it all went really parallel with the love we get over here when we play here. All the artists too. It's just the appreciation for the type of music we do specifically is really, really rewarding and really big over here.
We love the food, we love the people. They're super humble, super friendly. Really respectful, and we like it in Asia, and I think this is just the beginning. It's gonna be way bigger and way more crazy, and Asia, be ready for the Brown family, for Looney Tunes. We're gonna be back, we're gonna see you soon. We're gonna fuck you guys up.